5 years ago, Billings Flight Service pushed the envelope of helicopter aviation. It became the first commercial owner-operators of CH-47 Chinooks. Now, since then, the behemoth twin-rotor choppers, owned by brothers Gary and Al Blaine, have flown the globe. Now the company is pushing that envelope once again. Q2 Chief Photographer Paul Humphrey takes us to the skies to show us why these Billings helicopters could quickly become the most sought-after firefighting resource in the country.
That was one of the first ever water drops from a CH-47 Chinook helicopter. Built to deploy troops and equipment for the United States military, these six-blade workhorses now have a new mission. Billings Flying Service has been battling blazes with their Chinooks for 4 years using a bucket to dip into lakes, ponds, and streams to douse the flames. But using a bucket on an airframe the size of a Chinook posed a problem.
The trouble with the Chinook is that we have a bucket hanging underneath, sometimes 150 to 200 feet underneath of the helicopter. And with the regulations that are in place, you're not necessarily allowed to fly over houses and cities and towns, populated areas, with that bucket. Clearly that hinders our ability to fight fires.
So to solve the problem,
we have decided to put a tank inside of the helicopter.
But that created a new problem.
There isn't one that exists, so we had to design one.
Billings Flying Service didn't simply put a tank in their choppers. They developed and created the first ever tank and snorkel system for a Chinook helicopter. That system includes hydraulics independent of the helicopter's hydraulics, a disbursement pump, foam actuator, retardant intake nozzles, and one-of-a-kind bomb bay doors engineered to let the pilot evenly disperse water or retardant.
Our doors, depending on what kind of fire you're fighting, whether it be a house fire or a long grass fire or a single tree burning in the woods, you want to have a little bit different drop pattern for every one.
And the innovation doesn't stop with the hardware. These birds are also updated with new satellite technology.
It also has what we call telemetry. It immediately sends a message to the Forest Service how much water this helicopter dipped out of a pond and where we actually put that water.
With their repurposed warbirds equipped as modernized air tankers, the Blaines are confident their investment will pay off because the fire bosses on the ground want their helicopters in the air.
With the Chinook, we're generally the first call to the fire. They get the best piece of equipment out there early and fast, and this is clearly it.
In Billings, Paul Humphrey, MTN News.
Very cool. Thanks so much, Paul. Now, the FAA was in Billings this week to inspect and approve the modified aircraft. Gary Blaine says formal written approval could be as early as the first week of May.